forgiven us. And versus the 100 denarii, many times we don't want to forgive. And we will look here at the key word that God is moved with compassion and tenderness from his, from the innermost being of, he, of his being when we ask him for forgiveness. That was very important for us to be moved also, to be moved from within inside also to forgive. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the Eucharist. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy. To God in the highest and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is the flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant, and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live for the Lord. And if we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
we have to do in life. Jesus tells us in the gospel that we have to forgive 77 times. Now, in Hebrew, 77 is like hitting the lottery. It's in Genesis 4:24. It tells us that 77 is a number used to signal an uncertain, nearly indescribable amount. In other words, there's nothing greater than that. So Jesus is telling us today for that forgiveness is one of the greatest things that we can do. So why is that? Because no matter what we've done in our lives, the hundreds and thousands of sins that we've committed, the wrong we've done, the hurt we've caused others, God has still forgiven us of those sins. Totally and completely forgiven us. It makes the 77 number look really, really sad. Think about it. If each one of us commits just 100 sins in our lives and there are 7 billion people on this earth, God's forgiven 700 billion sins. And that number, I'm sure, is awfully low. But He does this because He loves us. Not because we deserve it. Not because we've earned it. Because He loves us. You see, forgiveness is not an emotion or a feeling. Unlike love, where we feel love toward somebody, forgiveness is a decision. A decision to release an offender of their offense. No matter how bad it was, it is our decision to release that person of that offense. And the desire for humans is a gift from God. We're given at birth this innate ability not only to love, which we do, but also to forgive. It's there inside of us, wanting to get out with this path to let it do so. And God knows how hard it can be for us humans and how stubborn we are. So He still gives us this gift then to forgive. Father Mike Smith suggested that if we're hurt today, if we're really hurt badly, that we might try to put a value on what that person has done to us, then tally up how much that person owes us. For example, put a value on what they have taken away from us, such as our peace of mind or our self-respect, or how much suffering they have made us go through. How they have destroyed our home, our family, our children. And then after writing all this down and trying to come up with some kind of number to assign it, take a look at that number and then tell yourself that person is free from paying back that number. Wipe away clean. Completely forgiven. On May 13th, 1981, as you may recall, John Paul II, who was our Pope at that time, was shot 2 times by an assassin. And the man who shot him was sentenced to life imprisonment. Well, John Paul went to visit him 2 years later and forgave him for trying to assassinate him. And even in fact, many years later, John Paul would come and visit him, and they became fast friends. Well, few of us have ever had something that hard to forgive, but there are certainly many things that we have bent up in our hearts that need to be forgiven. Somebody that's hurt us badly. Now, we're not called to forget that hurt. Our minds are not made that way. It will always be in our head. Those terrible things that are done to us can be very, very hard to forget. Nor are we called not to punish those who break the law, as was the man who shot John Paul. But we are called to forgive. You see, if God can forgive us for doing that to His Son, then He that we can forgive others for hurting us. The late Bishop Fulton Sheen once told the story about a man who was about to be executed for something he didn't do. Just before his execution, he said the following prayer: Heavenly Father, I offer up for the sins of these men and for my own sins the death of your son. But I also forgive my executioners as you forgive me. And so on judgment day, when these men stand before you, the angels will ask what charge is brought against these men. There will be no one to charge them with guilt because they were already forgiven. Sounds familiar? It's what our Lord Jesus said as he was being nailed to this cross with his hands and his feet when he told the executioners, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they're doing. Our hearts are made for love. Our hearts are made for love, not to hold a grudge, not to hate someone. The longer we hold a grudge, the longer we fail to give or to forgive, the harder it becomes to do so because our heart is full of the anger and the hatred caused by that grudge, by that thing that happened to us. And this leaves our hearts with no room for all that love that it should have. And why would we not want our hearts to be full of love instead of anger, instead of hurt? We would rather have it full of love to be at peace, not only with ourselves, but with everyone else. So if you have a grudge against someone, if you harbor hate in your heart somewhere because of what somebody did to you, let it go. When you come to the altar, let it go. Give it up to God before you take it in and say, God, this is yours. I don't want it in my heart anymore. You can have it. Get it out of your heart. Let your heart swell with love for Jesus Christ and for your fellow human being. Forgive, and God will forgive you. We have something to talk of a sensitive nature, which we plan to address following communion today. We're letting you know about this should some of you want to step out with your children, or maybe you're not listening to it at all of yourselves. Right after communion, this announcement will be made. This announcement will be on the parish website this afternoon at 4:00, and it will be part of the Mass live stream that can be found on your Facebook page. And Father Andrew will tell us about this after communion.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were
suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Our Father asks us to forgive others as he forgives us. In our intentions, let us seek forgiveness and ask for God's mercy.
For our church, which brings healing to penitents through reconciliation, may it never cease to us as we strive to do his will. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace throughout the world, especially here in our country and Ukraine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have lost their lives recently from storms and fires, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unborn, may they be given the gift of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For sincerity and a sign of peace, we will give to one another during Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For protection for the military, firefighters, and policemen, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick or dying, for those whose names are written in the St. Jude Book of Intentions, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Jean Kirsch, a long-time beloved staff member of our parish, who passed away Friday evening, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Victoria Colson, Mark Northcutt, Dagoberto Garcia, Andrew Bartolio, Patrick Johnson, Jose Carlos Altamiranda, Juan Reynoso, and Rosalina Astoria, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Ron Staves, in this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This morning in the Angelus, the Pope said to bring someone into your heart, bring someone to mind, and pray for that person. So let us take a few seconds and ask in your heart, Lord, I want to forgive this person, okay? Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Kind and merciful Father, slow to anger and rich in compassion, we ask that through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, you may give us the gift of forgiveness, that you may also help our hearts not to keep that resentment, so that we can give you grace and praise. Just to ask that you may help us to cope with the situations that we endure every day, for the injustices, and that can we also grow in the imitation of Christ Jesus. We just ask that you may listen to our petitions and bring it to fulfillment to our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn found in your white songbooks, number 107, Wonderful, Merciful Savior, number 107.
Who would have called out the land?
Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, Gregory, his auxiliary Bishop, and all and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, in the O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you. of your sacrifices and come into his courts. Adore the Lord in his holy temple. Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is remitted. Blessed the man to whom the Lord imputes no guilt, in whose spirit is no guile. Bring up your sacrifices and come into his courts. Adore the Lord in his holy temple.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto. Sicut erat in principio.
Communion hymn is found in your white songbooks, number 99, Taste and See, number 99.
Thank you.
taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Just as a reminder, we do have something to talk of a sensitive nature, which we plan to address after the prayer after communion. So we are letting you know this, should some of you want to step outside with your children after prayer, or really anyone that would like to step outside, you're welcome to do so. The announcement will be on the St. Jude webpage about 4 o'clock today. Also, it is part of the viewing on Facebook of the live stream of the Mass.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sit down.
So we do have the following communication to address to our parishioners. We are deeply saddened to share the news of a disturbing incident that has come to our attention. The St. Jude community has been a victim of a crime. A lay employee who was hired in the summer of 2022 passed away unexpectedly last week. And according to established procedures, we went to collect his computer and his personal items from his desk. Attached to the computer was an external hard drive that was not parish property. After a quick review, the hard drive appeared to contain suspicious and immoral content. The diocese security team was called in to inspect, and it was discovered that the content was not just immoral, it was illegal. Unbeknownst to the parish, this employee had set up a camera to videotape individuals in the single restroom between the church and the chapel, which is located on the west side of the church. This is a grave violation of privacy and morals. Upon discovering this, we immediately contacted the police and reported it to them. The police promptly came to the parish to collect the camera, the computer, and the external hard drive. They also did a sweep of the other bathrooms and found no other recording devices. We are currently cooperating with the law enforcement investigation and will continue to do so. Additionally, we have done security sweeps of our campus. On Friday afternoon, a specialized law enforcement unit trained to detect hidden electronics came in to conduct a sweep of the parish. We have determined there are no other cameras in any other restrooms. We are currently reviewing other security technologies that will help us to continue to work diligently to ensure the safety and well-being of all members of our faith community. We have not seen any recordings from the camera, so we are not able to answer if you or a loved one has been recorded. We simply do not know because it was handed over to law enforcement immediately and without any staff viewing it. At this point, the matter is in the hands of law enforcement. If you have further questions or you should wish to speak to someone about safe environment, you may call Brenda Martinez. And again, this information will be on the website starting at 4 o'clock, also, of course, on the live stream. But her number is 214-379-2812, or there's an email as well, bmartinez@cathedal.org. We do want to reassure that we are dedicated to safety in our churches. This incident represents a disease, an illness, an evil that is more widespread than we would like to believe. For this reason, we must remain diligent in following our safe environment policies and procedures. We will continue to offer prayers for those who may have been affected by this. So it is a sad to give this information today, of course. And we do keep each other in prayer as we recognize that there is hurt, knowing that this has happened in our community. I've asked Father Ricardo to do a special blessing just to strengthen us as we process this information.
to ask the Lord to send the gift of the Holy Spirit. How many things are unreasonable, but we need the grace. This allows us to desire even more the grace of God in us, each one of us. So bow down to receive the blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Look, O Lord, on the prayers of your family and grant them the assistance they humbly implore, so that strengthened by the help they need, they may persevere in confessing your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God be glorified, our Lord, by God.
Thanks be to God.
Let's join in singing verses 1 and 4 of the recessional hymn, number 856, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven, number 856.